reflection analysis allows the user to identify possible specular reflection points on the hop and evaluate the application of various specular reflection reduction methods. To open the reflection analysis window, click the corresponding button on the main panel. You can change the following parameters: K-factor, for which the reflection points are searched, polarization, vertical or horizontal. To reduce the effect of reflected wave, it's recommended to select vertical polarization. Reflecting surface type, the type of surface from which the reflection occurs. Each surface type has its own values of relative dielectric constant and electrical conductivity. The relative dielectric constant is a dimensionless parameter. It's automatically determined when depending on the reflection surface type, but can be modified by the designer. Electric conductivity is automatically determined depending on the reflecting surface type from above, but can be modified by the designer. If checkbox consider clutters to the reflected path is active, then when the incident of the reflection rays intersect with the ground obstacles, this rays will be screened. The path profile displayed all possible direct and ground reflected rays for the main-to-main antenna path, and in the space diversity configuration for the main diversity and diversity to main path. The table below will show the distances and the clearance at each of the reflection points. It's recommended that reflection points be determined for large K-factor values, at least 10. You can view a relative Rx power versus K-factor chart for any reflection point and any of main-to-main, main-to-diversity or diversity-to-main path by clicking on the desired point in the table. In addition, you can also display time delay versus K-factor chart. On this plot, the relative signal delay in nanoseconds between the direct and the reflected signal is displayed for each of the main-to-main, main-to-diversity or diversity-to-main path. If the reflected signal delay is greater than 10 to 20 nanoseconds, performance problems on the high-capacity systems can occur. If there are specular reflection along the path and you are not going to use space diversity, the application can estimate the effectiveness on the following methods for reducing the effect of reflected ray on the resultant signal for systems without space diversity, recommended an ITU recommendation 530. Increase the path inclination. Shielding the reflection point, moving the reflection point on the poorer reflecting surface, reductions of path clearance, choose of the vertical polarization. In most cases, these methods, except the last one, are limited to selecting the primary antenna height in the on the right or left. The most efficient way to eliminate the effect of specular reflection is the use of space diversity technique. The most often used technique is the vertical space diversity. MLinkPlanner allows you to determine receive antenna heights with enough space to maintain an uncorrelated direct and reflected signal, so that when the receive signal level for the primary antenna is zero, in fact, the signal is near to peak for the diversity antenna and vice versa. The right hand part of the window displays the heights of the diversity antenna determined based on the optimum antenna spacing as in the recommendation 530. In the case when receiver signal levels at the primary and secondary antennas must display a maximum difference, maximum and minimum, across the full range of the K-factor to minimize the effect of specular reflection on the received signal level. To estimate the effect of space diversity, perform the following steps. Select a space diversity configuration from both side A and side B. Then select the reflection point for each path using the mouse button. Select one of the optimum heights of the secondary antenna from the series of the right section of the window using the mouse button. You will then view the received signal level for each antenna on the chart. By changing the antenna height, you can see how to receive a signal level will change. In space diversity configuration, if the vertical spacing between the antenna is less than 200 times on the wavelength, which is a common rule for reducing the effect of multipath propagation on the performance indicators. A warning will appear next to the spacing on the profile, and its value in meters will be displayed. In order to determine heights of the primary and secondary antennas in the space diversity configuration, the following condition must be met. The maximum difference between the received signal level of the primary and secondary antennas might be observed across the full range of K-factor to eliminate the effect of specular reflection. The primary and secondary antennas must be at least 200 times the wavelength to eliminate the effect of multipath propagation. The primary and secondary antennas must satisfy the clearance criteria described in ITR 530 recommendation.